Here's a GE Porta Color 2. And I've seen some with rocker switches up here. This one has a regular on-off knob, an automatic button. This is color and tint, brightness, and the contrast slider's missing. QA chassis. So take the hood off. This is how I found it. Not even sure if this actually goes with this or not. This service panel must be in place before operating receiver. I don't know, where does it go? It'll go down there for now. And, boy, the lens is fogging up. It's so humid out here. Alright. 10-8-BP-22, grade AA color picture tube. All new components and materials, including rare earth phosphorus. There's some parts in here. We can see that. This is the horizontal output transistor. This section is not screwed in, so we will not be attempting to power this up at the moment. Get this board down here. Is that supposed to be like that? Yeah, I guess so. Well, I wanted to test the CRT. See if it's any good. And this has a date code of 7419. So the tube is from 1974. JA chassis fabricated in Singapore. I think this is a QA chassis, 10QA. So looking for some other date code somewhere. Nothing I can see at the moment. Well, all right, let me get the tester hooked up. All right, so we adjust the filament voltage. And we do have some light in there, so it's a bias B. And they had a note in here about these. It's, what did it say? 10-VA-BP-22. Note. Test normal except red back and black and white checks green gun and G tests red gun. Okay. Well, other than that, let's see. Shorts. No shorts. No shorts. Gun balance. We got some cutoff. Well, we got good emission on the red gun. Let's go over to the green gun. Good emission on the green gun. Now on the blue gun, or whatever the reverse of all of this is. So, I guess we got a fairly decent tube. Push the life test. Holding up pretty good. Yeah. Alright. Well, we have a good tube in the Porta Color II. I wouldn't have shit canned this one anyway, but the Porta Color II passes the test.